this is Mike. Thank you so much for choosing this video. Today I'm in Whiteville, North Carolina, visiting Van Underwood Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, and I'm checking out a 2017 Dodge Charger Daytona 392. Now this vehicle has been upgraded with a ton of features, lots of cool stuff to show off. Now it is fresh off the truck, so it's has not been detailed. So we're dealing with a dirty Daytona here, but it's awesome nonetheless. Let's go ahead and check it out. This Daytona is sitting on 275/40 ZR20 Pirelli tires. They are all-season performance tires, and they're wrapped around a 20-inch matte black alloy wheel, looking awesome. It also has a high performance brake system, Brembo brake system, with the ventilated and slotted oversized rotors in the front and rear. Now you have the calipers with 6 pistons in the front and 4 pistons in the back. The name of this color is Go Mango. Brand new color for 2017. Looks fantastic, especially with all the black accents. You can see it has the black, a matte black decal there with the Hemi name across the center of the hood, really accenting that hood bulge there with the hood scoop. And then you have the Daytona name here. Now it has these protectors still here on the front of the vehicle, and they're going to stay on it until the customer buys it, those green things there. You also have the adaptive cruise control. There's the radar system for that. You have the gloss black bezels around the headlights. Now it has a LED accent around the headlights. And the headlights themselves are in a projector tube for your high and low beams. It's a bifunction HID powered headlight system. You also have LED fog lights here at the bottom. So this is what your key looks like. It's a proximity key system. So it's designed to where you can just keep it in your pocket and use the vehicle. But it does have some useful buttons here, lock and unlock, the ability to open up the trunk, and remote start and a panic button. The physical key is on the inside here, which you can take out in case you need it. But generally, this can just stay in your pocket the whole time. Check out this 392 badging here on the side. Looking awesome. You also have a light right in here on the door, so as you open up the door, it illuminates kind of like your the whole side of the vehicle and the ground in front of you, like an approach light, I guess you could say. So basically, if you have the key with you, you can have it be in your pocket or whatever. You walk up to the vehicle, you can lock the door by pushing this button, and it'll lock it up for you. To unlock it, you just put your hand under the handle, it senses the key within a close proximity of the vehicle, and it will unlock the doors for you. All right, so here's the inside of the passenger door, and it has a all soft to the touch around your arm here, as well as here, and all the way up here, all soft to the touch surfaces. You have the gold contrast stitching all in the door, really looking nice. Look at that. Has a pocket at the bottom, has the premium Beats sound system with the subwoofer in the trunk. We'll check that out in a minute. Here's your threshold area. Power seats here on the passenger side with the four-way lumbar adjustment. You have the suede, really nice heated and cooled suede seats here with the kind of like a smooth texture-free leather here on the ends, and then the nice comfortable soft suede here in the center with the gold contrast stitching. Check it out. And then you have the gold Daytona name embroidered in the back of the seat. Very comfortable seats in this vehicle. Plenty of leg room. The floor mat hooks in place so it doesn't slide around on you. You have the Daytona badging right here in the dash. Lockable glove compartment, all felt lined with a little shelf system in here, keeping it organized. You have a decal across the back of the vehicle with the Daytona name, kind of blends in with the deck lid spoiler. You also have the whole top of the vehicle is wrapped in that decal as well. Okay, let's take a look at the back seat area. Inside of the back door is all soft to the touch, just like the front. It has the contrast stitching just like the front. There's some pockets, even a bottle holder. There's your threshold area. Heated back seats as well, with the same suede and leather on the side. Same design and pretty good bolsters for a back seat. So even with the seats all the way back, you still have plenty of legroom back here, and the floorboard is quite a ways down there to keep your knees from sticking up in the air. It kind of gives you a pretty good amount of legroom. Now, it's basically a bench seat, but it does have some bolsters on the end and more of a flat spot in the center for a center passenger. There's some cup holders, little storage compartment here in the armrest, which you can move out of the way like so. Now, it does have a significant hump here in the center, so the center passenger would have to deal with that. Heated seat controls and two USB chargers. So they must have paid attention to what people do when they get in the back seat, plug in their device and charge it or whatever. Especially on long trips, it's pretty much a necessity now to have a USB port handy. All right, taking a look at the back of the vehicle, has the LED taillights. Really looking nice. You should check out, I actually have a video of a 16 Dodge Charger at nighttime, so you can check out what the lights look like. This one would look like that one, so you can get an idea. Really like this black here in the back with the spoiler. Right in the very center, you have the backup camera. Parking sensors across the back. Dual exhaust with the pretty awesome exhaust tips back here. And speaking of that, now would be a good time to kind of show off the remote start. So let's go ahead and double tap the remote start. And you just hit the remote start again to turn it off. Had to hear that engine, which we'll listen to it more in a few minutes. But let's take a look at the trunk. Now, there's a couple ways of opening up the trunk. You can use the key, or you could just push this button right over here. Kind of blend it into the black, and it goes up all the way for you by itself. Here's your cargo area. And pretty good size. I mean, it is a four-door sedan, so you have a typical four-door sedan trunk, I guess you can say. Does have the Beats sound system. There's your subwoofer. Two points of light up back here, so you have one little light there as well as there. And then all the speakers are covered up, so you can see there's no wires hanging out. You don't have any metal or anything like that. Under here, doesn't have a spare tire, but it does have a tire inflator kit. There's all the original papers and everything that came with the vehicle, which Van wants to save for the new owner. And then you have a pretty large battery back here. And it's pretty neat because this thing has a little hook, so you can just hang it right there, hold it up so you don't actually have to hold it up. And you see that little funnel right there? I'll explain what that is in just a second. And if you need more cargo space, the back seats actually fold down in a 60-40 split fashion, so you can have a combination of cargo and passenger space when you need it. The fuel door is lockable, and it's on the driver's side, which is convenient. Open it up, and it's a capless design, so you don't even need a fuel cap. It does require a funnel, that little funnel I told you about, to use a gas can, but other than that, you just put the nozzle in at a gas station and fill it up. You don't have to worry about a cap being loose or the check engine light coming on, anything. It even has this little rubber seal to go around it just for extra, keep things from going in there. It does have a two-stage inlet, so it's not like you can easily get in there. To start it up, if you don't use the remote start, You just have to have the key inside, put your foot on the brake, hold it, and push this button. You don't have to hold the button, you just push it. Floorboard in front of the driver's seat. You can see it, the floor mat hooks in place in two places over here, keeps it straight and keeping it from sliding around on you. You even have the aluminum pedal covers with the raised rubber grips. Place to put your foot here on the left side, this foot rest right here, and a foot actuated parking brake. So let's go and take a look under the hood. To open the hood, there's a latch a little bit to the right of center. Right in here, just move it to the left and you lift the hood up. Doesn't take much energy to lift it up. Actually goes up after a certain point all the way by itself. And you see that hood scoop goes all the way through there. All right, and there's your latch. Okay, let's take a look at the engine bay. The whole firewall is insulated for the most part. You access the brake fluid underneath that cover. And check it out, it has a cold air intake. Right in there, there's your intake there on the top. Has some little bit of a plastic covers there on the ends that say powered by SRT. But generally, you can see the whole engine, which is great. Okay, so this big monster of an engine is a 6.4 liter V8. Now this one, since it has the MDS, to where you can, basically it saves gas while by cutting back to four cylinders. Multi-displacement system is what it stands for, MDS. And that way, when you don't need all the power, it'll just run on four cylinders, just cruise it on the highway or whatever. And it's seamless. You don't really know the difference whether it's in four or eight cylinder. It does have an active exhaust system to make it sound good, even if it's in four cylinder mode. Now this engine is paired to an 8-speed automatic transmission. And if you haven't experienced the 8-speed transmission, it is fantastic. So you have to take one for a test drive. All right, here's the inside of the driver's side door. Now it's just like the other side, except for it has a few more buttons. We already saw the little button down here hidden for your fuel door. But right in here is your door lock controls, your power window, and then your front two are automatic. So you have one touch down and one touch up. Now let me roll it back down and show you something. It does have the laminated glass here. So you have two panes of glass with an acoustic material on the inside, laminated, so it keeps sound from entering the vehicle as well as giving you a stronger pane of glass here on the side. Side mirrors are adjusted right in here. You have two memory seat positions for your power seat. And speaking of that, here's your power seat controls with the four-way lumbar adjustments. Really love these seats. Fantastic looking. All right, so right in here, here's your headlight controls, and you have an automatic, off, parking light, and then on. And then to turn on your fog lights, you just push here in the center. Interior dimmer switch for your interior gauges is here, and then ambient light is right there. So it does have pretty cool ambient lights, which you should check out my night video for that. Ability to open up the trunk, and it also has a tilt and telescoping powered steering column, so you can adjust it, fine-tune it the way you want it, pretty easy. here on the side mirror is a little triangle. You see the little approach light there right below it. But that triangle is part of the blind spot monitor system. And basically, when there's a vehicle in your blind spot, that little triangle will illuminate. So your blind spot is from your side mirror there all the way back to one car length behind the vehicle. So while you're on the highway, if there's a vehicle in that spot, it will let you know by illuminating that triangle. Now, if you put a turn signal in that direction, not only is it going to flash that triangle, but also give you an audible alert to keep you from changing lanes and sideswiping somebody. Now, that triangle is also used for the rear cross path detection system. Now, the sensor is right in here in the rear corner panel, and it can sense vehicle in the blind spot as well as vehicles approaching from either side. So if you're perpendicularly parked like these vehicles over here and you're backing out of the space, you may not be able to see around the vehicles next to you. So the sensors in the rear of the vehicle will let you know if there's a vehicle approaching from either side. Okay, let's take a look here on the inside. Really impressed with the comfort of the seat. I have the lumbar adjusted, the seat adjusted. I have plenty of leg room. I can almost put my legs completely straight out. I'm 6 feet tall, and I have plenty of knee room here. All right, also impressed with the carbonite accent around the bezels there. It's pretty nice. Okay, but before we go too far, I'll show you what the window sticker looks like so you can use the pause button if you want to get some information off of it. And look at all that optional equipment. The optional equipment starts here, and typically the optional equipment won't start till the next line, but this one has it all down there. Look at all that added extra stuff there. All right. 25 on the highway, 485 horsepower. Doesn't seem to match, but that's the case. And actually, some people are getting a little bit more than that. It's pretty interesting. All right, so let's go ahead and start here on the steering wheel. And it's a leather wrapped steering wheel. And check it out. Looking awesome. And it has the smooth leather, or texture free leather, whatever you want to call it, here on the end, right here at the top and the bottom. See if it'll focus for you. Yeah, there we go. So the smooth, and then it goes into this perforated leather here on the ends. It goes up into this grip, and then you go back into the smooth leather there. And it has the paddle shifters on the back. There's a plus, and then the minuses on the other side for changing through the gear ratios if you want to use that. Just below it is a volume for your radio with a center button that will cycle through AM, FM, satellite radio, and kind of your different audio sources. And on the left side, just below this paddle shifter, is another toggle switch with a center button, and it'll cycle. The up and down will go through your, like, your stations or your audio tracks, and then the center button will cycle through your presets. But here on the front of the steering wheel, you have your cruise control here on the right side, and it's not just a normal cruise control. It has the adaptive cruise control. So the whole radar system in the front I mentioned will match your speed to vehicles in front of you, basically. So if you're driving on the highway, you have your cruise set at, say, 70 miles an hour, and there's a vehicle in front of you going 68, instead of having to, you know, change and reset your settings there, the adaptive cruise control, when it's on, will slow the vehicle down to match their speed. Now you can adjust your distance from the vehicle in front of you there to, you know, different car lengths. So when you push the button, once it's on, so you can see these, kind of gives you these bars here, letting you know how far away you can be from the vehicle in front of you. So I like a real far distance, so it gives me more reaction time, but sometimes in heavy traffic, you can't be too far away, otherwise people will get between you. Then you have less space. Okay, so here on the left side is your Bluetooth controls. You answer calls, hang up, you have voice recognition system that's very advanced. Not only can you, you know, make calls, receive calls, you know, you basically make calls with your voice recognition, but you also change the radio station and climate control and all kinds of different things by using your voice, and that keeps your hands on the wheel, eyes on the road. These buttons correspond with this screen between the gauges, which we'll get to in just a minute. Your windshield wiper controls are here on your turn signal. All right, so looking at the gauges, you have this nice red glow in the background, sort of like the taillights has that nice glow. And the letters have like this sporty kind of font to them, looking pretty cool. And your RPMs are here on the left, and your speedometer is on the right. And right here in the center, you have a whole bunch of information that has the outside temperature here at the top right. You have your range at the top left. Now those are customizable. You can have different information there if you want. And then your fuel gauge is right in here. And on the left side is your engine coolant temperature. And your odometer is there in the center. But right here in the very center, you have a digital speedometer. And you can actually change that information if you want by using these buttons. So once I scroll down, just kind of show you here, scrolling down reveals that this is part of a whole menu system. So right now it's showing a speedometer there at the top right there, and you can see a little one right next to it. When I move it, see it now, it's 1, 2. All right, so scrolling down, this goes into the vehicle info, and then you see those little bars at the bottom that's showing you that you can get more information by scrolling to the right. So right now it's showing the tire pressure. Scrolling to the right, goes into the coolant temperature. Again, goes in transmission, then the oil temperature, oil pressure, oil life, battery voltage, intake air temperature, engine torque, which is pretty cool, is real time, and your horsepower, so you can see that real time as well. And then it goes back to your tire pressure. Scrolling down again, goes into your performance. This is where you have a 0 to 60 timer, 0 to 100, eighth of a mile, quarter mile, braking distance, and G-force meter here, so you can see lateral or front and back. And then you have the peak G-forces, what the vehicles had max, and then you can reset that. And there's your lap timer and your lap history, and top speed, 67 miles per hour is what it's showing. All right, scrolling down again, goes into your driver assist. This is where you can see your distance between you and the vehicle in front of you with the adaptive cruise control. You also have a fuel economy, little, kind of looks like a gauge to where you can see what you're getting average as well as real time. Trip info, this is where you shows not only your distance traveled but also your average miles per gallon during that time, and your timer at the bottom. You can reset that. You actually have two trips. You have an A and a B by scrolling to the right. Scrolling down, you go just kind of showing you what your radio is doing. 8 will store your messages here, like when it's time to change the oil, that kind of stuff. And 9 is your screen setup. This is where you can change the little things there on the corners. So upper left, upper right, see how it illuminates the little red there showing you what it's talking about. The center, and you can change the gear display and all kinds of different things. Even your odometer if you want to take that away. So that's pretty neat. Let's go back out of that, and scrolling down again goes back to your digital speedometer. So that's kind of a quick rundown of what you can do on the screen there. You don't have to go in there and adjust all that if you don't want to. It's just there in case you need it. All right, looking at that carbonite accent right here, this bezel around the edge. I don't know if you can see that, but looks awesome. Has a little bit of a texture too. It's not smooth. Has a little bit of a rough texture. Okay, so looking at the 8.4-inch Uconnect system, the Uconnect system is very easy to use once you know a few basic principles. It has these icons here across the bottom, and they pretty much stay there to where you can know where to go. Right now we're in the radio screen, and you can see it shows the radio station. You have option of AM, FM, satellite radio. You have your presets, your favorites there at the top. You can adjust the audio right here, so you can adjust your fade, equalizer. It even has speed adjusted volume as well. All right, next icon will be your media. This is where you can play music through a USB ports, auxiliary, or your Bluetooth input wirelessly, like off your phone or something like that. Climate, Right now it's set to auto, so we could just set the temperature and it'll kind of adjust for us. But if we want to manually adjust the temperature, we can go, your driver and passenger can sync like they are now. They can sync them together, or you can unsync them and have separate dual zone climate control. There's where you want the air to blow, front and rear defrosters, recirculate the air and your air conditioning and all that. You even have a quick access to go into your heated and cooled seats, as well as your heated steering wheel controls. You even have the ability to go into your settings, which are a ton of them here. Next one is your apps, and there's tons of, these are basically your, basically like your icons here at the bottom, but all of them that the vehicle can have. Go into all those. Now you could actually change different information, the icons are at the bottom. So if we want to take this performance pages, so your phone is right here. Let's look at the phone real fast just to show you. Once you pair your phone, you have access to your contacts and your recent calls, and you have favorites here at the top. You even have the ability to transfer it back to your cell phone if you want to have a private call. So let's go back to apps. Let's take this performance pages, press it, hold it, and slide it down there and replace that phone icon, so that way we don't have to have the phone if we don't want to. You also have the ability to install Apple CarPlay or Android Auto in this system. That's new for 2017. All right, so the next thing here is your controls. This is basically just the shortcut we already saw that goes into this screen. And then let's check out the performance pages. Takes a second for it to load up. And this will kind of give you the give you some performance information, as you know, that's why it's called performance pages. All right, so you have timers right here on the screen. You have gauges, second option for your gauges, your G-force meter, which is pretty cool, and what your engine is doing here. Now you notice it has the oil pressure, has the torque, horsepower, all on one screen. It's pretty awesome. All right, let's close that out. And we already saw the settings here, so you can see all that stuff. So that's your icon. So once you get used to it, it's pretty easy to just go right where you want to, and you can customize the icons as you see fit. You also have a clock here at the top, digital compass where it says S, outside temperature, and then your interior, what's your interior temperatures are set at for your dual zone. So down here is another button that gives you another screen, your super track pack. Let's go ahead and push that, and it will pop up this screen here. Now this vehicle has a launch control, which you can activate. Say launch control here. We don't want to activate. It won't actually activate until you reach, I think, 500 miles or something like that. And you can adjust the way the vehicle launches at a certain RPMs. Then you can adjust the drive mode. You can set up the engine and transmission, the paddle shifter, traction control, steering, just the way you want it. You can have sport mode. You can adjust the engine transmission to sport or normal, paddle on or off, traction control, you can have it on sport or normal, and then your steering could be sport, normal, or comfort. So with the electronic steering, you can have a stiffer by having on stiffer steering by having it on sport. Comfort will be really easy to turn, and then normal will kind of be in the middle. And then you can set up your default there. So you can set it up independently and check it out the way you want it. So once you have it customized in the Super Track Pack, you can just push the sport button and it'll be exactly the way you customized it. So the traction control is here, and if you want to spin tires, you're going to have to turn this off. So you push that button, it turns off traction control, or it goes to a more of a sport mode. You push it and hold it, and it's going to disable the stability control. In addition to that, so you have the ability to just really go, you know, however you want to drive the car. A lot of safety features are turned off when you do that. That's why you have to push and hold it so they know that you want to actually do that. Okay, so you have a traditional volume tuned through the stations here, and your right in here is a button, and that's your lane sense. So that way it'll, if you're driving along and the lane sense is beeping at you, letting you know if you're going out of your lane or something like that too much. If the lines on the road are not good, then you can turn that feature off right there. You can also turn off your parking sensors if you want to. You can mute the radio. There's your four-way flashers. And your climate control, you can control it on the screen, or you can also control it here with your front and rear defrosters, temperature, fan speed, all that good stuff. All right, so you have a little storage pocket right in here with a little rubber liner and a 12-volt power supply that's backlit illuminated. And you see it has a key there letting you know that it will turn on and off with the ignition. Little place to put some stuff. That's a good place to put the key as well. And it has the Dodge Brothers name in the bottom. Okay, so here's your shifter here, and very comfortable shifter. Let's go ahead and put it in reverse. Now, two things are going to happen when you put it in reverse. The backup camera will pop up here, and it has the active guidelines, which you could turn on and off if you want to in the settings. And you can see from the bumper to the sky all around. It's a wide angle view to give you a good visibility back there. But the second thing that's going to pop up is your parking sensors here. So if you get close to something while you're backing up, not only will it beep at you, but it also give you an indicator, a visual indicator there, where the actual thing is. So we're left, right, or center. So that's pretty handy as you're backing up. Continuing down, there's neutral, drive, that's your normal drive position. If you want to manually change to the gears with the shifter, just move it here to the left, and it's kind of like a ratchet shifter, so you have negative and plus, so you can change to the gears, and you'll know what gear you're in because it'll show right here on the gear selector. So it says go put it in drive, and then when I put it in manual, you see that one, and then I can put it in second gear. It won't let me go too far out of range to help so you don't mess up the engine or whatever transmission. But that's pretty cool. Now, if you're using your paddle shifters, or if you're driving and you accidentally hit your paddle shifters, if they're turned on, they will change gears. It's not a big deal if you do that. To put it back in drive, you just press and hold the plus, and it will go back in drive for you. All right. Now, this right here, I don't know what material this is, carbonite, but it is cold feeling, so I don't know if it's actually a metallic material or not, or it just could be the way the material is, but it's pretty interesting. Alright, so you have this place here that rolls back, and you have illuminated cup holders, and it's open here in the center as well as right here, so you can utilize that space for other things besides just cups. And this is kind of like a rubberized material. You have the gloss black accent there. Alright, so here's your armrest, and it's soft to the touch, very comfortable and soft. It's big enough to where you can share it with your passenger, I suppose. It depends on how generous you are. And you have the gold contrast stitching here on the end. And this lifts up, and you have a felt-lined storage compartment here with this little tray that's removable. And this is where you'll find two USB ports, your auxiliary input, and a 12-volt power supply. Now, this one has a battery on it, letting you know that it's directly connected to the battery, and it's basically on even when the vehicle's off. So that's handy for if you want to charge the cell phone when you go into the store, and you can leave it charging while you're in the store or whatever. All right, so the rear view mirror, it's an auto dim rear view mirror, and it's actually auto dimming right now because I have the shade over the light sensor here, but also the side mirror on the driver's side is auto dimming as well. The rearview mirror has the ability to, it has its own cellular connection, so you can get roadside assistance and emergency help there on the side of the road, even if you don't have your cell phone with you. It's pretty cool. All right, place up here to put your shades, and it has like this foam material on the inside to protect them. You have a floodlight and a spotlight, so you have two sources of light there, depending on your needs. Your HomeLink garage door opener controls are here. You can see it's all backlit buttons up here. This is for your sunroof, which we'll get to in just a second. Now, your visor has mirrors and lights, has the ability to extend out if you need to, as well as pull out this little extra shade there. All right, so the sunroof has a shade that covers up 100% of the light. So no light is coming through now. You can open it up manually. And let's go ahead and vent it up so we can get a little bit of air coming in. You can open it up all the way. Like so. And of course we can always close the shade. Okay, let's look at the visibility in the back. So, has a pretty significant pillar there in the back, but the headrests don't really get in the way very much. The rear headrest anyway. But you do have the side glass that goes out back quite a ways. And of course you have all the cameras and sensors and everything to help you back up, and the blind spot monitor and all that good stuff. All right, okay, so there you have it. Awesome vehicle. Let me know what you think in the comments. 2017 Dodge Charger Daytona 392. Has a nice rumble to it. I don't know if you've noticed that in the video. You can hear it in the background. At least I can hear it. I don't know if it's picking it up, but looks awesome. Really like the color. And it's just a really nice muscle car. You know, it just has that classic muscle car look and sound, and it has the power and everything. Very impressive. So thank you for watching. Thank you to Van Underwood Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram here in Whiteville, North Carolina, for allowing me to show off this vehicle. See you next time.